Kharkiv, as is known, is the scientific, cultural, and educational center of Ukraine. What was the effect of war on these spheres? What are the future prospects? How the scientific is and cultural community experiencing modern challenges? Today we are discussing these and other issues in the new project, Perspectives, in which we plan to synthesize the conversation about culture, science, and education.
The guest of our program is the well-known Ukrainian businessman, philanthropist, diplomat Sergei Politaki. Sergei Yakovich, good day. Good, glad to see you.
Sergei Politaki, born March 14, 1954, is a Ukrainian businessman, philanthropist, owner, founder and president of the group of companies Factor, candidate of economic sciences, honorary consul of France in the Kharkiv, Sumy, and Poltava regions. In 1991, Sergei Politaki founded and headed the scientific and production enterprise Factor. In 2002-2006, he was a deputy of the Kharkiv City Council. From 2004-2006, he held the position of the first deputy mayor, was an advisor to the chairman of the Kharkiv Regional State Administration on socioeconomic issues. In 2008, by the decree of the President of Ukraine, Sergei Politaki was awarded the honorary title Honored Economist of Ukraine.
Sergei Yakovich, let's start with your diplomatic activity. You are the honorary consul of the Republic of France in the Kharkiv, Poltava, and Sumy regions. The first question, how exactly does this activity of yours relate to the aid of the Republic of France to Ukraine during the war? What functions does the honorary consulate currently perform?
Насправді, я повинен сказати, що насправді почесне консульство своєю задачею, уставною задачею має
In fact, I have to say that the honorary consulate, by its statutory task, is to provide all kinds of assistance to French citizens who are on the territory of our country. And it was like that before the war, before the active phase of the war. We helped the French who found themselves in a difficult situation on our territory. But with the beginning of the invasion, I can't say that the functions changed, but our internal attitude to our functions completely and fundamentally changed.
Нельзя сказати, що функції помінялись, але наше внутрішнє відношення до наших функцій цілком докорінно змінилося і багато роботи ми проводили, я проводив особисто
And we carried out a lot of work, I carried out personally, in France, during all these 2 years. During the time I repeatedly met with representatives of diplomatic missions, various structures, and all kinds of public society centers, in order to tell them why the war started, why, in the event of a negative development of events, Europe should prepare to oppose Russia. And that is why it is most important to help Ukraine now, right now, in order to ensure calm and peace not only for Ukraine. But also for the whole of Europe.
У разі негативного розвитку событий, подій, бути готовими до протидії Росії, і тому найбільш важливо допомагати зараз, саме зараз в Україні, і от на для того, задля того, щоб забезпечити спокій і мир.
I think that all of us who have tried to influence public opinion in France made a contribution from our consulate in this great work. I am very pleased to see how France, in the face of the head of state, is now taking on a role, a responsible role, for the fate of Europe, for the fate of the future of Ukraine, and we are very grateful to France for the help it provides to our country.
Спостерігати, як Франція, саме Франція в ліце очільника держави зараз беруть на себе свою роль, відповідальну роль за судьбу Європи, за судьбу майбутнього України, і ми дуже вдячні Франції за ту допомогу, яку вона оказує нашій державі.
I know that you are personally acquainted with the ambassador of France to Ukraine. Tell me, when you communicated some joint events, are there any targeted projects related to Kharkiv that the French government plans to implement in the framework of the activities directed at Kharkiv support?
Відносно Харкова, якісь цільові заходи, які це має бути там реалізувати французький уряд?
Я повинен констатувати, що насправді ситуація у сенсі спілкування з Заходом взагалі і Францією в частності, вона дуже-дуже затримується, тому що, по-перше, ситуація в регіоні дійсно дуже-дуже небезпечна. А по-друге, ви знаєте, це дуже цікаво, але, мабуть, це закономірно.
Unfortunately, I have to state that in the sense of communication with the West in general and with France in particular, there is a lot of delay. Firstly, because the situation in the region is actually very, very dangerous, and secondly, on the one hand it is interesting, on the other hand it is natural. The question is what we fear more than anything. We fear some kind of uncertainty. Therefore, when they observe the events in Ukraine from abroad, for them, everything that is happening in Kharkiv looks even more dramatic and catastrophic than it really is. Therefore, all our conversations about cooperation, sisterly relations, and so on, as a rule, face the answer, okay, it's very cool, it's very interesting, we will definitely be happy to communicate and cooperate, but... And this, but, means after the war ends.
Це насправді досить утопічно розраховувати, що багато співпраці, обмінів гражданами і так далі може відбуватися у цих обставинах.
And it is actually quite utopian to expect that a lot of cooperation and exchange of citizens can take place in these circumstances. But right now, in my deep conviction, is the time to build those relationships. It is terrible and scary to say so, but it is thanks to the fact that now the attention of the whole world is focused on Ukraine, we can reach our partners with our efforts, PR efforts. To talk about our problems and to be heard, what is most important, to be heard. Therefore, it is not necessary to count on the fact that right now any investments will come. Any humanitarian or reconstruction projects will be implemented.
Услышаними, що саме найважливе, то бути послухані. І тому розраховувати, що саме зараз всюди прийдуть інвестиції, будуть виконуватися якісь проекти гуманітарні чи реконструкційні.
But in any case, we need to communicate right now, which is exactly what we are doing, trying to reach our partners. And what is most important now is not to let public attention from abroad weaken. It is important to keep attention to Ukraine on the agenda, as they say, so that war fatigue does not happen and Ukraine remains the center of attention of our partners until the victory.
Як кажуть, питання України для всього світу, щоб ота втома від війни не трапилась, і щоб Україна була в центрі уваги наших партнерів до перемоги.
In 2024 alone, France plans to provide up to 3 billion euros in military aid to Ukraine. In February, the presidents of Ukraine Volodymyr Zelensky and Emmanuel Macron of France signed a bilateral agreement on cooperation in the security sector in Paris. This agreement was the third such agreement to implement the G7 joint declaration. About 65,000 refugees from Ukraine are currently under temporary protection in France.
Тепер до суті нашого проекту, тому що наш проект.
Now let's proceed to the essence of our project, because the project is dedicated to science, education, culture, and you. As a person with many virtues, connected with all these areas, let's start with science. I have such a question to ask. You are a practicing businessman. The main goal in your life is business. But you are also a candidate of economic sciences. You have a large number
number of scientific works. Why exactly did you decide to do science? Why do you need this type of activity? What field of science do you work in? What was your PhD thesis dedicated to?
Навіщо вам займатися наукою? І скажіть, будь ласка, як це саме це, якою саме сферою науки, економічної науки ви займаєтесь? Чому присвячена була ваша кандидатська дисертація?
Ну, це дуже багато, дуже таке складне запитання, та не складне, мабуть, а многошарове таке запитання.
This is a very complex question, not even a complex one, but rather a multi-layered one. It is necessary to start with the fact that I started doing science when I worked in the housing and communal management of the Kharkiv region. And I was very interested in discovering the quality of regularity in the processes taking place in this economy sector.
Якісь закономерності у процесах, які відбуваються у даному хазяйстві, в частності.
In particular, I was interested why in Soviet times one of the biggest problems in the utility industry was continuous leakages on communal networks, on water networks, on sewage networks, but first of all on water supply networks. Some of the breaches continued for months before being repaired. And I was interested in whether there was any regularity between such situations and the environment in the broad sense of the word.
Ремонтують. І мені було цікаво, існує ли яка закономірність між цими поривами і якимось навколишнім середовищем в широкому сенсі слова. В частності, я провів дослідження.
In particular, I conducted a study and was able to give an answer to the question, what does this unpleasant phenomenon depend on the one hand, and on the other, how many people are needed and how these people should be organized so that these repairs are carried out as quickly as possible and with the highest quality. That is, the dissertation was devoted to the organization of work in the housing and communal economy.
Швидше і якісніше. Тобто, дисертація була присвячена організації труда у жилищно-комунальному хозяйстві на прикладі обласного управління водопроводно-каналізаційного хозяйства. Потім,
using the example of the regional management of water supply and sewerage. Later, when you have such a critical mindset, and when you are interested, naturally interested in discovering regularities, discovering relationships between some phenomena, it becomes a way of thinking. Therefore, in the future, when I managed my own business, I realized and believe that it is extremely important to transfer practical knowledge to students.
І вважав, що дуже-дуже дуже-дуже важно
Even while they are still studying in the walls of a higher education institution. Therefore, we founded a branch of the Department of Economic Security of our Kharkiv Institute of Municipal Construction Engineers, currently the University of Housing and Communal Economy. And it lasted for a very long time and back in those days, every week we conducted, I mean our specialists, good specialists, very proficient specialists.
Зараз університет жилищно-комунального господарства. І це продовжувалось дуже-дуже довго. І в ті ж часи ми, окрім того, що єжетижнево, ми проводили наші спеціалісти, дуже гарні спеціалісти, висококласні спеціалісти, проводили заняття з студентами факультативно. Но, крім того, ми
conducted classes with students on an optional basis, but in addition, at the same time, we founded the auditor competition. Accordingly, there was the auditor 95, and so on and so forth, annually. About 1,500 students from all over Ukraine took part in the competition. During three rounds, we selected the finalists and seven students received a one-year scholarship from Factor, three times more than the state scholarship and the right for employment in the group of companies, Factor.
стипендію протягом року, більшу, ніж державна стипендія в 3 рази, і право на трудоустройство, працевлаштування у компаніях групи «Фактор».
In 1991, Sergei Politechnik founded and headed the scientific and production enterprise Factor, from which the development of the group of companies Factor began, which included 5 enterprises, including the Factor Drug Polygraphic Complex, the publishing house Vivat, and the media company Factor Media, as well as the auditing firm Factor Audit and the network of stores for development goods Razum. The group of companies Factor is a member of the European Business Association.
Sergei Yakovich, let's talk about the challenges of war and the prospects of science. You, on the one hand, as a scientist, economist, on the other hand, as a practicing businessman, how do you see the prospects of Ukrainian science at this time? How critical are the challenges of the war for the Ukrainian science?
Мабуть, я скажу деякою мірою дивні речі, але, на мій взгляд, на мій погляд, от то така банальна фраза, що...
Perhaps I will say strange things, but in my opinion, such a trivial phrase that challenges give birth to solutions, good solutions, despite all the drama of the situation in which we find ourselves, this phrase is very, very appropriate. In my opinion, it is the only thing we need to do right now. That's my opinion as a businessman, a systemic businessman, that I also evaluate the government activity from the position of a systematic businessman.
Тому я і на державну діяльність дивлюся з позиції якби системного бізнесмена. На мій погляд, перше, що потрібно зробити і у цій галузі теж, і не тільки у цій галузі.
In my opinion, the first thing to do in this field, and not only in this field, is to make a certain summary analysis. Summary analysis of where we are, what our competitive advantages are, and what our weaknesses are. In the future, we must adequately look at the situation and answer the question, how many universities are needed in Kharkiv after the end of the war? In my opinion, Ukraine has fantastic opportunities for the development of science itself.
Саме у Харкові потрібна вишив. Ну, на мій погляд, Україна має фантастичні можливості для розвитку саме науки. Но наука повинна стати, на мій погляд, такою галузю, яка не тільки...
But science should become, in my opinion, a branch where scientists not only work to satisfy their scientific ambitions, but also to implement their ideas into some projects that really push the science, economy, and technology of the state forward. It requires a lot of money, of course, but, first of all, in my opinion, it requires a change in attitude towards science as such. Transformation of science from a thing in itself into a thing for the world, for the universe.
Дуже багато грошей, звичайно, але, ну, на мій погляд, в першу чергу це потребує зміни відношення до науки як такової, перетворення науки із речі в себе.
Society has a very limited knowledge of what scientists do and what achievements they have in our country. And at his point, when we talk about science, in my opinion, once again, a comprehensive analysis should be made in order to show in which fields of science we are the strongest and which fields need further assistance, first of all.
На мій погляд, ми знов-таки SWOT-аналіз должен показати, в яких галузях науки ми найбільш сильні і які галузі потребують допомоги в першу чергу.
Ми з вами це спілкувалися дуже багато на тему того, як має держава підтримувати науку, освіту, культуру, і говорили, що це дійсно...
You and I talked a lot about how the state should support education, culture, and science, because a developed state is one that has fundamental science, classical universities, and academic culture.
culture. Tell me, in terms of Kharkiv, what do we need to do now at the state level in order to support these trends, which were developing very well in Kharkiv before the war and are now developing in some spheres, so that we can preserve the status of a student city? What should the state do for this right now?
Щоб ми зберегли наш статус студентського містечка, що має держава для цього зробити зараз?
Що стосується студентського містечка, то, мабуть, одна з найбільших болей, які я відчуваю у контексті даного питання. І я, ну, відверто кажучи, я зараз не бачу ближайші роки перспективи відтворення Харкова саме як студентського містечка, тому що ці 200 тисяч студентів.
As for the status of a student city, one of the biggest pains I feel is that, frankly speaking, I do not currently see, in the coming years, the prospects of re-establishing Kharkiv as a student city, because those 200,000 students, including 20 or 30,000 foreign students, they are unlikely to return to Kharkiv until, as Professor Pobedonostsev said, an iron peace will come to Kharkiv, eliminating any possibility of missile or other threats.
В Харкові існувати не буде. Тобто, тому я й кажу, що надо, ну, потрібно тверезо дивитися на майбутнє і сказати собі так.
That is why I insist that it is necessary to look soberly at the future. And saying yes to ourselves, it is a task for all of us to do our best, so that Kharkiv once again becomes a student city, the most student city in Ukraine. But before that, in parallel with that, we should think about what the system of our higher education institutions should look like during the war and after its end. What the state should actually do.
Що повинна зробити держава? Ну, насправді, ми можемо зараз, ну, говорити про що завгодно, але насправді, ну, держава, є лише одне слово. Це
we can talk about any efforts, but in fact, the state has one factor, peace. Because only when there is peace, students from all over Ukraine and from all over the world will come to Kharkiv, our hospitable Kharkiv. As long as there is no stable peace, the development of the student educational process does not seem very possible to me. As for science, in my opinion, now is the time when science can become a practical helper for industry, for military industry above all.
Уявляється не дуже перспективи не дуже можливим. Щодо науки, ну, на мій погляд, саме зараз час, коли наука може стати практичним помічником.
Because it is scientists who can now carry out the tasks of creating the latest means of defeating the enemy and other needs that are now very important for our army and for our military industry that provides the army. The state should find certain resources to support Kharkiv science, Ukrainian science, especially since our fundamental, mathematical, physical, chemical science has deep roots, a deep foundation, and, I hope, have many prospects.
І для нашої промисловості, яка забезпечує армію, держава повинна знайти якісь ресурси для підтримки харківської науки, української науки, тим паче, що наша, я наскільки знаю, фундаментальна математична, фізична, хімічна наука має глибокі коріння, глибокий фундамент і, ну, я сподіваюся, має...
Scientific research in Ukraine first began to acquire a systematic character in the 17th to 18th centuries with the creation and development of the Kyiv-Mohyla Academy and the Lviv University, where, however, the humanitarian sciences were mainly developed under the dominant influence of religion. Science in Ukraine gained significant development in the 19th century, when Kharkiv, 1804, Kyiv, 1834, and Odessa, 1865, universities were founded, which which became the scientific centers of Ukraine and foreign scientists, were involved in teaching, which made it possible to create own scientific schools of high level. The establishment of the Ukrainian Academy of Sciences, later the National Academy of Sciences of Ukraine, in 1918, and the subsequent establishment of a number of scientific institutions within its structure were decisive in the development of the Ukrainian science. Currently, the largest scientific center in Ukraine is the National Academy of Sciences and its 168 scientific institutions.
Let's get back to business. As a person who is continuously circulating in this process, can you give a view from the middle of this process? How do you see the current development of business during the war in Kharkiv? How is it developing at the time when the war is going on? What prospects do you see? What trends, development trends, do you see in this difficult time?
A very interesting question. Very difficult, yet again interesting. It is difficult because, in fact, no matter what we talk about Kharkiv, no matter what branch of the national economy, culture, education we talk about, we face the same problem, security. And that is why business in Kharkiv is going through very difficult times. In fact, business doesn't work, business survives, as they say. Why? It is clear that industrial enterprises are constantly in the crosshairs of enemy attacks and they face the possibility of destruction. And everyone understands that. This is not only the physical destruction of production facilities, but also a possible physical destruction or harm to the people who work in these enterprises. This is a very difficult situation when, in my convincing opinion, school children, students, and many workers are now left without socialization.
Соціалізація, якою зараз і школярі лишилися, і студенти, і багато...
Socialization is a very important issue and, in fact, in my opinion, business as such, in addition to the purely business component, the pursuit of profit also has such a very important social role because employees communicate offline at the company, act as mentors to each other, exchange thoughts, and in general, a person is a social being, and therefore communication is extremely important. But we don't have that opportunity now, and therefore...
спілкуючись онлайн, офлайн на підприємстві, вони, ну, і виступають якби менторами відносно один одного, обмінюються думками. І взагалі,
I would say that all the enterprises of the group are currently rather surviving in the hope of victory, in the hope of returning to peaceful times when we worked the way we worked before. I believe that those who work now in Kharkiv are heroes, and they need and deserve all kinds of support, both at the state level and at the local level.
І на повернення мирних часів, коли ми працювали так, як ми працювали до того. Тому ті, хто працює зараз у Харкові, я вважаю, що це герої, і вони заслуговують і потребують, заслуговують всілякої підтримки як на державному рівні, так і на місцевому рівні.
On April 30th, 2024, by the decision of the extraordinary session of the City Council, entrepreneurs in Kharkiv were exempted from paying taxes for land, real estate, and the single tax for physical entities entrepreneurs of the fourth category. According to the decision, from April 1st to June 30th, 2024, the tax liability for individuals, legal entities, and entrepreneurs after charging rent for land plots of communal ownership was canceled. In addition, single taxpayers of the fourth group were granted a 100% reduction in tax liabilities.
Сергій Яковлевич, меценатство, культура, меценатство.
Сергій Яковлевич, let's now talk about philanthropy, culture and patronage. You are a well-known philanthropist in Ukraine, a person who invests a lot of effort and money in the development of cultural projects. As the head of the theater, I should mention that we have a lot of joint projects with which you help the theater, some projects we started together with you. Namely for you, what is philanthropy? Which projects that you finance and support are the most important and close to you?
Це знов-таки дуже складне і дуже многошарове таке питання. І складне, ну, в першу чергу, тому що
This is again a very complex and multi-layered question. And it is difficult because what I can answer you can seem very pompous, but it is true.
Деякою мірою таким ну, занадто пафосним. Але це правда.
Whether it is pompous or not, but I know that you invest certain funds.
І правда, це я багато думав, розмірковував над цим явищем. Колись багато років тому до Харкова прибула
Many years ago, a delegation from our sister city Nuremberg arrived in Kharkiv. And the vice mayor of the city asked me to accompany one of the members of the delegation. A large businessman who was engaged in the production of garbage trucks. I come from a utility industry. I knew the structure, the people very well, and during the day, I visited utility enterprises with this guest. We had breakfast together, and then I offered him dinner at my house, to which he replied that it was very good. I called my wife and told her that we would have guests. Those were the times when we had a foreigner as an alien. We had to show him what a beautiful country we have, what good food we have, how coolly we live.
І я йому запропонував ужин у себе вдома. І він сказав, да, дуже добре. І я зателефонував жінці і сказав, так і так, у нас буде гості. А це були часи, коли для нас, ну, іностранець це був як інопланетянин якийсь. І ми повинні були показати йому найкращим чином.
Then in the evening, I don't remember exactly, they had some kind of event and he refused to stay because he was invited to an official meeting. And when I returned home, my wife told me that when she found out about the foreign guest, she started cooking and at the same time putting the apartment in order.
І він відмовився, тому що, ну, був запрошений на офіційну якусь зустріч. І коли я повернувся додому, мені жінка розповідає. Каже, ну, коли я почула, я почала готувати щось і паралельно
Then she went into the vestibule and realized that the vestibule also needed cleaning. And then she went out into the corridor of our 16-story building. She went to the elevator, and as the events took place in the 90s, the elevator at that time was often misused a toilet and such. And she reached the elevator and almost began to wash it, but then she remembered about the hall on the first floor and the road from the house to the parking lot.
Там, я знаю, туалет і все, і так інше. І вона каже, я дійшла до ліфта і вже майже почала його мити, А потім я вспомнила про хол на першому поверсі і дорогу від собто до
And decided that she could not prepare clean everything and stopped at that point. I'm telling this story to demonstrate that when your scale is a little bigger than your apartment, then you want to live not only in a beautiful apartment, but also in a beautiful place, city and state. And if you have the energy to realize your desires to live in a beautiful world, in a beautiful universe, you should work hard on it.
А ти хочеш жити в квартирі в красивому місці, місті і державі. І якщо ти маєш енергію для того, щоб свої желання, оте бажання жити в красивому світі.
And that is why it is so important for me that my beloved Kharkiv, my Ukraine, will always be the place, the state that I can be proud of, in which I could live comfortably. And for this, you need to slightly adjust the environment and the surrounding world. I strongly believe that culture and music are like mathematics for the brain. By the way, I once sent my son to study in the mathematics class, realizing that he would not become a mathematician.
Трохи коригувати навколишнє середовище і навколишній світ. По-моєму, на моє глибочайше переконання, саме культура і музика – це як математика для мозка.
But I understood that mathematics develops logic, develops thinking. So music, too, develops thinking and logic, and develops brain in general. And although we may not notice it, but it definitely works. The more people will enter the world of music and the earlier it will happen, the more chances that a harmonious personality with a humanitarian vision of the world will grow. A person who, in the humanitarian sense, will be more mature and emotionally beautiful than one who lacked this in life.
Чим більше людей будуть заходити у мир, у світ музики, і чим раніше це буде відбуватися, тим більше шансів, що виросте гармонічна особистість з гуманітарним баченням світу, людина, яка в гуманітарному світі.
That is why the festival Kharkiv Music Fest is so important. We are paying a lot of attention in the framework of this festival to work with children, which is related to music therapy. During the 2 years of war, we had more than 200 meetings with school children, especially with children who moved to Kharkiv from war-affected areas. And this is now gaining special meaning and significance.
Приділяємо саме роботі з дітьми музичною терапією. За роки війни, оці два роки, ми мали більш ніж 200 зустрічей з школярами, особливо з дітьми, які переселилися до Харкова. І це набуває зараз особливого сенсу.
Because not all of us are yet aware of the fact that Kharkiv has already become a different Kharkiv during these 2 years. After all, according to various estimates, I'm really not sure that I can say exactly now, but I heard that there are 300 and 400 and even 500,000 displaced people who now live in Kharkiv.
В тому, що я скажу точно, але я слышав і 300, і 400, і навіть 500 тисяч переселенців зараз проживають у Харкові.
Харків Мюзик Фест. Скажіть, будь ласка, ну, ми знаємо, що Харків Мюзик Фест за кілька років став одним із самих
Back to Kharkiv Music Fest. We know that Kharkiv Music Fest has become one of the most powerful festivals in Ukraine in a few years. Classical music festivals. We know a lot of sub-projects of this festival, including the Children's Festival, which you already mentioned. There were a lot of events taking place there. The so-called painted pianos, which are located in different corners of Kharkiv, are available during this event. Tell me, please, how do you currently see the prospects of development of this festival?
Це головна любов, мабуть, я маю на увазі Харків Music Fest. І це дуже прикро.
Kharkiv Music Fest is my special love, the main love.
До того,
and it is very unfortunate that the war and previously the coronavirus very much restrained and continue to restrain our development, making it practically impossible today. I mean the fulfillment of those high tasks that we set before ourselves. That is, we brought to Kharkiv, if we can say so, performers whom the Kharkiv audience had practically no chance to see here if it were not for the Kharkiv Music Fest Festival. And these are very expensive, highly paid musicians.
Шансу побачитись десь, якби ні фестиваль Харків Мюзик Фест. Це дуже такі дорогостоячі, коштовні виконавці.
Kharkiv Music Fest is the international classical music festival. It has been held annually since 2018. Concerts with the participation of world-renowned maestros, large-scale musical projects, unprecedented events within the framework of the festival form its unique face and turn it into a driving force of the process of cultural development in Kharkiv and in Ukraine. Kharkiv Music Fest does not only feature concerts with world-class classical music stars, but also a large-scale program of non-concert projects and events.
Коли почалася війна, активна фаза цієї війни, на наш погляд, команда фестивалю, я пам'ятаю, ми з вами на цю тему не раз говорили, і сенс фестивалю
When the war began, the active phase of this war, we have already discussed it, the sense of the festival was adjusted to a certain extent. And now, I would say the main meaning of Kharkiv Music Fest is everything that begins with the prefix co-dash, cooperation, co-sympathy, coexistence, and so on. We see the festival and it seems to me that the festival has fulfilled its role to some extent and is still fulfilling it. This is a platform that should unite our professional musicians for cooperation.
Він свою роль, оцю роль виконав і виконує. Це така площадка, яка повинна об'єднувати для співпраці і наших професіональних музикантів, я маю на увазі у інституції, музикальні установи міста, котрі потерпають і дуже-дуже потерпають, особливо позаминулому, в 22-му році.
I am referring to institutions, musical institutions of the city, which are currently suffering a lot, and especially suffered back in 2022. We provided a great deal of help to our University of Culture and other cultural institutions, libraries, and so on. We feel some responsibility for the cultural layer of our city in these difficult times. For example, the first festival we held during the war, in the spring of the year before last, held in the subway.
Ну, наприклад, той перший воєнний фестиваль, який ми провели, я не пам'ятаю точно, але весною позаминулого року у метро. Звичайно, це був концерт і концерти, які в музикальному, в музичному сенсі не були, звичайно, чимось таким особо незвично видаючимся, але
These were concerts that were not too extraordinary and significant in the musical sense, but we saw how important it was for musicians who played to the sounds of explosions and performed musical compositions in the subway, and for people for whom it was a signal that life goes on, that music is eternal and we too will live forever and everything will be fine with us. Now the festival will end with a big orchestra festival with the participation of Kharkiv artists, including our KH Natop.
Відкриття, і воно буде большим таким фестивальним оркестром з участю і харківських артистів, в тому числі і нашого Хатоба, або Хнатоба, да? Національне. Диригентом буде директор фестивалю, наш директор
The conductor will be the director of the festival Vitaly Alexianov, who is currently the chief conductor of the Opera Am Rhein. This is one of the most outstanding musical institutions in Düsseldorf, and he will also come to Kharkiv, and I hope that the level of these concerts and the atmosphere that will be there will be a significant contribution to peaceful atmosphere of our city.
І атмосфера, яка там буде, буде значним вкладом в мирну атмосферу нашого місця.
Оскільки ж ми знаходимося тут у нас, в нашому театрі, в Харківській опері, у нас традиційне питання, оскільки ви є не тільки меценатом, але це нашим
Сергій Яковлевич, we are now at the Kharkiv Opera Theater and I have a traditional question. Since you are not only a patron, but also our regular guest, our admirer, a friend of the theater, what theater part would be most appropriate for you personally? What character would you like to play if you had the chance?
Якщо б у вас була така нагода?
Дуже несподіване питання. Я ніколи не замислювався над цим, над такого роду питанням. І перше, що прийшло, це Гамлет, але я подумав, що, мабуть, це ну, дуже не банально, але ізбіто, як кажуть. А насправді...
A very unexpected question. I never thought about it. But the first thing that came to mind was Hamlet. But I thought that it could be not banal, but too trivial. In fact, if we talk about literature characters in a broad sense, it is Grigory Melikov from the novel And Quiet Flows the Dawn, who is closest to me. This answer is unexpected even for me, because I have never thought about this question.
Григорій Мелехов з Тихого Дону. Я, це відповідь така несподівана навіть для мене, тому що я не думав ніколи над цим питанням. Але, мабуть, тому я кажу так, що я декілька разів читав цей твір і читав його в юнацтві.
But I say so, because I read this work several times and read it in my youth, then in my student years.
Персонажу.
And the tragic fate of this character, it really impressed me then and is still interesting to me. It is interesting, because I lived his life more than once, certain moments of his life.
Я не один раз проживав, як би казати, його життя, в окремі моменти його життя, розмірковував, як би я поступив от тому чи іншому, в той чи іншій ситуації, які там описуються. І от драматизм і необхідність...
I pondered how I would have acted in one or another situation described in the novel, and that drama and the need to make dramatic decisions several times over several decades, it constantly returned my thoughts to the behavior of this character, the tragedy of his fate, his life, a life that actually reflects the lives of many people who went through all these dramatic events of that time.
Трагізмом його судьби, його життя, як життя, яке насправді відображає життя багатьох людей, які пройшли всі ці драматичні події того часу. І тому, якби я і грав, то, мабуть, і грав би сучасного, сучасного,
so, if I were to play, I would play modern-day Grigory Melikov in modern circumstances. Because, as I said, his dramatic story is very topical today.
Дуже, дуже схоже, дуже актуально.
Дякую.
Thank you. Let me remind you that our guest today was the famous Ukrainian businessman, philanthropist, diplomat, and public activist Сергій Політучий.
Громадський діяч Сергій Політучий.